Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Penny Pollard's Diary, written by Robin Klein and read by Rebecca Macauley. Details of other available and forthcoming Belinda Audiobook releases can be found at the end of this recording. The dedication reads, for Peter. Friday. I'm going to try very hard to catch malaria over the weekend. Poked a hole in fly wire in my bedroom so mozzies can get in. Hope they are proper malaria kind. Also will gargle with red food colouring so throat looks like scarlet fever. Do not want to go to school on Monday. Ms. James said our class going to visit nursing home for senior citizens and play our recorders for them and sing daggy songs from Sound of Music. Put up my hand and asked why our excursion couldn't be to a racing stable instead. Ms. J gave me snaky look. She never does to Simone, who is her pet. I didn't say anything about it being an excursion, Penny Pollard, she said. Senior citizens are not public exhibits at the other end of a bus ride. This is for your community work project. Nobody is too young to learn service to the rest of the community. She gave me extra snaky look, meaning she didn't think I was any shining jewel as far as social work concerned. Simone put up her hand and said she'd spend all her pocket money on roses, lace, hankies, chocolates to take to senior citizens at the nursing home. Ms. J beamed. Simone said she'd also bake a special cake and make whole lot of lavender bags trimmed with lace and ribbons as little surprise presents. If anyone gave me a present like that, I would kick them. I put up my hand and said, can I stay back at school on Monday instead of going on that excursion? Ms. J asked why. Told her I didn't want to visit a lot of old ladies. Told her I thought old people just plain boring and always talking about their rheumatism and asking if it's 3 o'clock yet because they have to take their pill. And they look creepy, like tired old trees in winter. I told her I would not go to that nursing home and that's all there was to it and I didn't intend to discuss the matter any further. I didn't say that last sentence out loud. Ms. J told me off for views on senior citizens, then handed out permission forms parents have to sign or we can't leave on the bus Monday for our visit to that dumb place. Hid my form in gumboot when I got home. Saturday. Mum met Simone's when she was doing the shopping. Just where is that form I have to sign for the visit to the nursing home, Penny? She said when she got back. You can wear your pretty pink dress Auntie Janice sent from Adelaide. What do you mean, yuck? I will not have that dress just hanging up in the wardrobe for months not worn. I don't intend to discuss the matter any further. Penny, how did this permission form get horse manure all over it? Feel sick every time I look at that pink dress from Auntie Janice. Auntie traitor. She knew very well I wanted a stock whip for my birthday. When the dress came, I got 5 strong, healthy-looking silverfish from the garage and put them in pocket and sealed it up with sticky tape. But they ate sticky tape instead of dress. Maybe dress made them sick too. Also tried shrinking it while Mum at work. Soaked it in mixture of Nifto foam carpet cleaner, super speed pot powder, anti-dandruff shampoo and dynamo car wash. That yuck dress must be made of special TNT-proof laboratory-tested material. It came out brighter and pinker than ever and didn't even need ironing. This afternoon, went over to Dairy and asked the man could I ride one of the horses and he said, like he always does, shove off, kid. Came home. Gargled with red food colouring and showed throat to Mum, fainting at the same time. She said, get up off the floor and stop being silly, go clean up that red food colouring mess in the kitchen sink. Sorted out my 350 swap cards into which has most pointy ears, longest tail, nicest face. No one at school likes my swap card collection except me. Everyone says, ace, ripper, when they see the box full of cards. But after they look through the first 50 and see they're all horses, they get mad and hand them back. Sunday. Rang up a racing stable and asked could I be an apprentice jockey there and the man said, how old are you, sonny? I said, 10 and my name's Penny. And he hung up. Went down to watch Annette Smurton get her horse Blaze ready for Pony Club. Asked her again could I ride him and she said, get lost. Found another old horseshoe in that big paddock. put it in my bedside table collection, which took 5 years to collect. Now have 47, counting good luck charms from Auntie Janice's wedding when they made me be flower girl and it was the worst day of my life. Mum baked big cake for me to take to nursing home tomorrow. Told her I didn't want to go to that place because old people give me the creeps. Mum got very mad and said that wasn't a nice thing to say, and how would I like it if I were an old lady and nobody wanted to come and visit me? Those old people will love having you children come to visit, she said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.